Hi, in this video I will show you how to configure transport management system between two different SAP systems. That is between development and production systems. Here we have the SAP easy access initial screens of both the systems. So this is SAP initial access system. SAP easy access screen of NWD system. So from here you can find out the client of the system, that is 000 client, and the user is DDIC. And in the same way, here we have another system, that is NWQ. SAD of the system is NWQ and the client is 000 and the user is DDIC. Okay, we are going to create a transport management system between these two systems. That is, one will be domain controller and another will be added to the existing domain. First, let us configure TMS in the first system, that is development system. Here you need to enter STMS T code. Hit enter. So this is the initial screen will be displayed in the system where the TMS is not already configured. Okay, as soon as you get this screen, just accept the defaults and click on the save button. And you just remember the transport domain name is domain underscore NWD and the description is transport domain NWD. Because we are going to add the next system into this domain using this configuration, this information, domain underscore NWD. And the system name is, that is SID of the system is NWD. Okay, just click on the save button here to finish the TMS in this mission, in this system. So the TMS is configured in this system. Just go down and you see you are logged on to the domain controller. Because we have configured the TMS in this system first, that's why it became domain controller. Okay, that means it is also called as communication system. All the configuration data will be maintained with this system. Okay, so that this configuration will be distributed to remaining systems which are configured in the group of this particular TMS. Okay, let us go to overview and click on the systems to display all the systems are configured in this TMS. Only one system is available right now. Okay, I am going to create a virtual machine before creating physical machine. Just click on SAP system, click on create, click on virtual system. From here you can provide the future systems which you are going to plan, that is NWQ I am planning, and the system, the description also you can provide system NWQ, and the communication system by default it will come, that is NWD, and the description is system NWD. Click on the save button. Okay, this is virtual machine. This denotes virtual machine, this symbol, that is X circle, X in the circle. And you can find out the information from this legend button also. You can get the information about all of the symbols. That is, this one is virtual system. And domain controller. This symbol denotes domain controller. This one is domain controller. And this is backup domain controller. And external system, like that you have all the symbols and meaning of the symbol. Okay, so just I am closing the screen and just I am jumping into another system to configure to add another system to existing domain, that is domain controller. Okay, just go to STMS again in this system also, same procedure but a small change, just hit enter. Here the same screen will be displayed in the second system also. If you click on the save button here, this system also will become domain controller. No one can control anybody. That means both domain controllers will be there. That means nothing is there to control. Okay, so instead of clicking on the save button, just you need to click on the other configuration button. Click on the other configuration. This is particularly important button. So in the second system you need to use this particular button. Click on this other configuration or F6 from your keyboard. Once you click on other configuration, you will be displayed with another screen. Here you need to provide the domain controller information, that is target host. It is asking what is the target host of our machine. So this is the target host. Host name is NWD. Okay, so you provide that NWD, and the system number is 00. That is, you can find out from system status, or you can also find out from your SAP management console, that is from physical system, that is NWD. From here also you can find out. So this is 00. Okay, number is 00. Okay, just give the system number here. Just I know that 00 is the number. Just click on the save button here. So once it is saved, just you will get this screen, that is SAP system waiting to be included in transport domain. That means, so without approval from the domain controller, you cannot add this particular system into the existing domain. Okay, you need to approve before continue with your configuration. Okay, so you can find out the system number from somewhere here. It's not available here. Okay, let it be. As we already included it, just remember that you can find out the information from SAP management console, that is 00, that is system number, not client number. Okay, and also called as instance number. You need to have the host name of the system and the instance number of the system to add your second system into existing domain. Okay, we have already passed that step. That is SAP system waiting to be included in transport domain. Just without doing anything, just click on the refresh button here. Just observe that this virtual system, the symbol will disappear. That means this particular virtual system became physical system now, because the physical system is already available and it is already added into the domain, existing domain. Just you need to approve from the domain controller. Just click on the refresh button here. Okay, it is refreshed and it is waiting for approval. The symbol denotes here is waiting to be included. You can find out the information from the legend button, that is here system waiting for inclusion in domain. And same type of screen you will get from here also. Just click on overview and click on the systems, so that you will get the same type of table here also. Okay, same thing. And waiting to be included, and the NWD, it is not actually the virtual system, it is physical system. Okay, okay, let us approve the system in the domain controller. That is, select the system which you need to approve and click on SAP system, click on approve, so that the system will be approved, and click yes in this dialog box. Accept system, include system and W key in transport domain. Click yes. Once it is approved, the status symbol will be changed to this candlestick. New transport group created for system and WQ. Okay, continue. See, both the status are active now and the configuration also is up to date. And the release of both the systems are 700, that is NetWeaver 7.00. Okay, system NWQ and system NWD. And here you just refresh, so that you will get the same status here also, like this. And now let us create routes between these two systems, that is two system landscape. Go to environment, click on transport routes, and click on the display or change button, and go to configuration and click on the standard system, that is a standard configuration, development and production system. You need to specify which is the development system and which is the production system, that is NWD here, and the production system is NWQ. Okay, and click on the continue button and click on the save button. and it will display one dialog box. In that you need to specify the description, that is to system configuration. Click on transfer. And do you want to distribute and activate the configuration across all systems? Yes, the same configuration will be distributed to all the systems. Here go to environment and click on transport routes to get the same type of figure here also, and click on the plus, that is zoom in button, to get bigger picture here also. So in this way you need to configure TMS between two different systems. I hope you understood well. Thanks for watching.